Hello students, today we are going to discuss about disaster management. So first of all, what is a disaster? A disaster is a sudden calamitous event. It is a suddenly happened event that disrupts the functioning of a community or society. So it is a sudden event that causes damage to society or community. For example, earthquake, volcano, flood, drought, etc. So this disaster results in damages to human, material, and economic or environmental losses. So because of disaster, there is a destruction of human life, human property, there is a loss of economic, and there is a loss to the environment. So if I speak about disaster in Indian context, so India, our country, which is also a subcontinent, sometimes it is called as a subcontinent, is very much vulnerable to drought, flood, cyclone, earthquakes, landslide, avalanche, forest fire. So you will see, if I speak about flood, so about almost 75% of the rainfall in India, it occurs during the rainy season. And because of which, we see the uprising water level of the rivers and occurrence of flood in many parts of India. So approximately 40 million hectares of land in our country has been identified as being prone to floods. About 40 million hectares of land in our country has been identified as being prone to flood. So especially this Gangetic and the Brahmaputra plain are prone to flood in our country. Similarly, if we speak about cyclone, so we are surrounded by sea on two sides and there is ocean on another side. That means three sides of our country is covered by water. So we frequently observe the phenomenon of cyclone. So India has a coastline of 5,700 kilometers, which is exposed to tropical cyclones arising in the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea. So we have about 5,700 kilometers of this coastline area, and which is very much prone to cyclone. So in India, cyclones occur between April and May, and also between October and December. So because of the cyclones, the coastal areas such as Orissa and these other coastal areas of Tamil Nadu are affected every year. Okay, droughts are also a frequent phenomenon in our country. So there are many parts of the country which have dry climatic condition. And because of the less occurrence of rainfall, when rainfall does not occur in these places at a average level, it occurs below the average level, then these places, they suffer from the drought condition. So most of the drought prone area identified by the government, lie in the arid and semi-arid areas of our country. Likewise, like the flood and the drought, our India is also prone to earthquake. So this impact of earthquake, it is mostly seen in places such as the this Northeast India and the Himalayan ranges. So almost 50 to 60% of India is vulnerable to seismic activities of varying intensities. So we observe as I said, the Himalayan and the Northeastern parts, they receive this frequent shocks of earthquake, and they are vulnerable to earthquake. So So what are the types of disaster? Let us see. So a disaster can be divided into two types, natural and man-made. So how do we classify natural disasters? Natural disasters, they can be classified as biological, geophysical, hydrological, and meteorological. Biological disaster means these are the disasters which are caused by biological agents such as our virus, bacteria, or fungus. So these are the biological disaster. So these biological disasters may be viral infection disease, bacterial infection disease, parasitic infection disease, fungal infection disease, prion infection disease. So this, if I say what is prion, prion is an infectious protein particle. So it is a, if a normal protein, if a good protein is somehow undergo, if it somehow undergoes mutation and if it converts into a harmful protein, then it known as a prion infection, infectious protein. So this protein can cause many disease. Example is your mad cow disease. Then another biological this disaster is your insect infestation or animal stampede. So as you are seeing now, this COVID-19, it is a viral infection disease, and because of these diseases, there is loss to life, there is loss to there is a loss to life. There are people suffer from emotional trauma. So after these accidents. So this is about your biological disaster. Next is your geophysical disaster. So geophysical disaster means, geophysical means it is related to the earth. So when the geophysical features of the earth, such as the mountains or the rivers or the plateaus, they are involved in some types of disasters, then it is our geophysical disaster. For example, earthquake, volcano, then rockfall, landslide, avalanche, and subsidence. So avalanche is the movement of rock or a movement of a block of ice or snow down the hill slope. And this can result in damages to animal life, human life, and property within a short interval of time. Next is our hydrological disaster. So it can be flood. So this flood is again of two types, that is three types, sorry, general flood, flash flood, and storm surge or coastal flood. General flood, we know whenever there is increase in the intensity of rainfall, then the water level in the rivers, it rises and submerges the surrounding area. So that is general flood. Flash flood means when the flood will happen because of the short amount of rainfall. Sorry, if the this flood happens within a short time because of rainfall, then it is known as your flash flood. So this flash flood is generally seen in the urban areas. It is also seen when a dam breaks. Whenever a dam breaks, then also we can see flash flood. So wherever a dam breaks, the water coming from the upstream of the river suddenly submerges the downstream areas of the river. So that is also known as flash flood. That means the flood which happens within a short period of time. Next is our storm surge or coastal flood. So this flood occurs in the coastal areas because of the tides or because of the earthquake in the under the seabed. Whenever there is an earthquake in the seabed, then this water from the sea and ocean, it submerges the coastal areas. So that is our coastal flood, like tsunami. Okay. Then mass movement is also there. Mass movement as if rockfall. Whenever if there is a heavy rainfall, and because of heavy rainfall, we know the soil become loose and unstable, and the soil of the hill slope, they can suddenly cause the rock to fall downslope. So that is the rockfall which happens because of the wet condition or which happens because of rainfall. So that is our hydrological condition. Landslide is can also happen because of hydrological conditions like rain or snow. So because of rain or snow, the land becomes unstable, and as a result, landslide can happen. Avalanche can also happen. This block or mass of soil can suddenly move down slope because of the rainfall or snowfall. Subsidence can also happen. A portion of the land can suddenly become unstable and it can just slide downward. That is known as your subsidence. Next is our meteorological disaster. That means the disasters which are related to our climatic or weather situation. So first one is our storm, which is tropical cyclone. That means the cyclones which occurs in these tropical regions of our country. Extra tropical cyclones means these are a little bit more harmful than the tropical cyclone because they are extremely low pressure cyclone, and they generally occur over a wide area, not within a small area. They will generally cover a large area. That is extra tropical cyclone. Local storm can also be natural disasters. Next is our climatic conditions like the extreme heat, extreme cold or extreme winter condition, drought, wildfire, forest fire or land fire. So all these are our natural disasters.